Hi everyone, welcome to Idea About video classes. Today our topic is straight lines. First let us discuss few basics in this topic. The first basic concept in this topic is coordinate system. Now first let us discuss about coordinate system. So coordinate system. Now first consider two perpendicular lines. Let them be x dash x and y y dash. Suppose these two perpendicular lines are intersecting at a point O. The point O is called origin. The line x dash OX is called x axis. The line YOY dash is called y axis. What is that one? The line x dash OX is called x axis. The line YOY dash is called y axis. In particular, the ray OX is called positive X axis and the ray OX dash is called negative X axis. The ray OY is called positive Y axis and the ray OY dash is called negative Y axis. This X axis and Y axis are together be called coordinate axis. What is that one? X axis and y axis are together be called coordinate axis. Now the plane containing coordinate axis is called coordinate plane. The plane containing coordinate axis is called coordinate plane. Plane means it is a flat surface. This coordinate axis divides the plane into four equal parts. Each equal part is called quadrant. What is that one? Coordinate axis divides the plane into four equal parts. Each equal part is called quadrant. Now here, this is first quadrant. It is second quadrant. This is third quadrant and it is fourth quadrant. First quadrant is formed with positive x axis and positive y axis. Second quadrant is formed with negative x axis and positive y axis. Third quadrant is formed with negative x axis and negative y axis. Fourth quadrant is formed with positive x-axis and negative y-axis. Now, how to represent a point in a plane? Now, every point in a plane can be represented by an ordered pair. Every point in the plane can be represented by an ordered pair. In an ordered pair, the first number is called x coordinate or abscis. In this ordered pair, the second number is called y coordinate or ordinate. Now here, the first number is called x coordinate or abscis. Here, this point. So, in the ordered pair, the second number is called y coordinate or ordinate. Now, let us discuss briefly about x coordinate and y coordinates. Now, what is x coordinate and what is y coordinate? First, draw the coordinate axis. This is x axis. it is y axis. Now take a pointer in xy plane. Suppose P is a pointer in the xy plane. Draw a line passing through the point P and parallel to x axis. Draw a line passing through the point P and parallel to x axis. The distance from the point P to y axis is called x coordinate of the point P. What is the definition? The distance from a point P to y axis is called x coordinate of the point P. Suppose if you denote this distance value with x, then x coordinate of this point P is x. What is the definition? The perpendicular distance from a point P to y axis is called x coordinate of the point P. Now draw a line passing through the point P and parallel to y axis. Draw a line passing through the point P and parallel to y axis. The distance from a point P to x axis is called y coordinate of the point P. Suppose if you denote this distance with y, then y coordinate of the point P is y. What is the definition of y coordinate? The perpendicular distance from a point P to x axis is called y coordinate of the point P. So first note down the definitions of x coordinate and y coordinate. The perpendicular distance from a point P to y axis is called x coordinate of P. Then come to the y coordinate definition. The perpendicular distance from a point P to x axis is called y coordinate of P. Y coordinate of P. For example, P is a pointer whose coordinates are 2, 3. 2 is called x coordinate of P. 3 is called y coordinate of P. Now draw the coordinate axis. Suppose this is your point P, 2, 3. Here 2 means the distance from the point P to y axis is 2 units. Here 3 means the perpendicular distance from the point P to x axis is 3 units. That is the meaning of x coordinate 2 and y coordinate 3. Now see once again the definitions of x coordinate and y coordinate. The perpendicular distance from a point P to y axis is x coordinate of the point P. The perpendicular distance from a point P to x axis is y coordinate of the point P. Now come to the next point, location of a pointer. Suppose P x comma y be a pointer. You can take the point P at anywhere in the xy plane. That means you can take the point P in first quadrant or in second quadrant, or you can take the point P in third quadrant or in the fourth quadrant. Suppose if you take the point P in first quadrant, then what is the sign of this x coordinate and what is the sign of this y coordinate? Similarly, if you take the point P in second quadrant, in such case, what is the sign of this x coordinate and what is the sign of this y coordinate? And moreover, if you take the point P in third quadrant, then what is the sign of this x coordinate and y coordinate? Now, we will discuss these four points one by one. Now, first draw the coordinate axis. Suppose this is x axis, this is y axis. Suppose I can take the point P, x, y in first quadrant. P, x, y be a point in first quadrant. How this first quadrant is formed? First quadrant is formed with positive x axis and positive y axis. So that x coordinate value is positive, y coordinate value is positive. So, if a point P lies in first quadrant, then x value positive, y value positive. It means x coordinate value positive, y coordinate value positive. So, P lies in first quadrant, then x coordinate value positive, y coordinate value positive. The point whose x coordinate is positive, y coordinate is positive, it lies in a first quadrant. For example, P is a point whose coordinates are 2, 3. This point lies in which quadrant? Here x coordinate is positive, y coordinate is positive. So therefore, this point lies in a first quadrant. Suppose if you take the point P, x, y in second quadrant. P is a point in second quadrant. Second quadrant is formed with negative x axis and positive y axis. So that x coordinate is negative, y coordinate is positive. If x coordinate is negative, y coordinate is positive, that point lies in a second quadrant. So, if a point P lies in a second quadrant, then x coordinate is negative, y coordinate is positive. The point whose x coordinate is negative, y coordinate is positive lies in a second quadrant. For example, P is a point whose coordinates are -2, 3. If you observe this point, x coordinate is negative, y coordinate is positive. So, this point lies in a second quadrant. Next, suppose if you take the point P, x, y in third quadrant. So, P, x, y be a point in the third quadrant. Third quadrant is formed with negative x axis and negative y axis. So that x coordinate value negative, y coordinate value negative. The point whose x coordinate is negative, y coordinate is negative lies in a third quadrant. So if the point P lies in third quadrant, then x coordinate value negative, y coordinate value is also negative. For example, P is a point whose coordinates are -2, -3. This point lies in which quadrant? Here, x coordinate value is negative, y coordinate value is also negative. So that this point lies in a third quadrant. Next, suppose the point P, x, y lies in a fourth quadrant. Take the point P, x, y in fourth quadrant. Fourth quadrant is formed with a positive x axis and a negative y axis. So that x coordinate value positive and y coordinate value is negative. The point whose x coordinate value is positive and y coordinate value negative lies in a fourth quadrant. So, if a point P lies in fourth quadrant, then x coordinate value positive, y coordinate value negative. For example, P is a point whose coordinates are 4, minus 3. Now, where this point lies? Here, x coordinate value positive, y coordinate value is a negative. So, this point lies in a fourth quadrant. Now, here we are discussing about a location of a point. See, once again, if the point P x, y lies in first quadrant, then x coordinate value positive, y coordinate value positive. If the point P x, y lies in second quadrant, then x coordinate value negative, y coordinate value positive. If the point P x, y lies in third quadrant, then x coordinate value negative, y coordinate value negative. If the point P x, y lies in fourth quadrant, then x coordinate value positive, y coordinate value negative. Now come to the next concept, basic line equations. Now in this concept we are going to discuss about four important points. First one is what is equation of x-axis, what is equation of y-axis, what is the equation of line parallel to x-axis, and what is the equation of the line parallel to y-axis. Now see the first point, equation of x-axis. What is the equation of x-axis? First, draw the coordinate axis. Now this is x-axis, it is y-axis, this point is a origin. Now take some points on x-axis, this is 1, 0, this is 2, 0, this is 3, 0. On negative x-axis also take some points. Suppose this is -1, 0, it is -2, 0. If you observe all points on x-axis, its y-coordinate value is 0. So, equation of x-axis is y equals to 0. What is the formula? Equation of x-axis is y equal to 0. What is the reason? If you take any point on x-axis, its y coordinate value is 0, so that equation of x axis is y equals to 0. Then come to the second point, equation of y axis. What is the equation of y axis? Denote some points on y axis. Suppose this is the point 0, 1, this is the point 0, 2. Take some points on negative y-axis also. This is the point 0, -1. This is the point 0, -2. If you observe all points on y-axis, its x-coordinate value is 0. So, equation of y-axis is x equal to 0. What is the formula? Equation of y-axis is x equal to 0. What is the reason? If you take any point on the y-axis, its x coordinate is 0. So, equation of y-axis can be taken as x equal to 0. Then come to the third point, equation of a line parallel to x-axis. Now, first draw a line parallel to x-axis. suppose this is a line parallel to x-axis. Now here, this distance is 1 unit, this distance is 1 unit, so this point coordinates are 1, 1. This distance is 2 units, this distance is 1 unit, so this point coordinates will be 2, 1. This distance is 3 units, this distance is 1 unit, so this point coordinates are 3, 1. Come to the left side of the line. This distance is 1 unit, this distance is 1 unit, so this point coordinates are minus 1, 1. This distance is 2 units, this distance is 1 unit, so this point coordinates can be taken as minus 2, 1. Now, if you observe all these points, its y coordinate value is 1. So, equation of this line can be taken as y equal to 1. Clearly, this line is parallel to x-axis and it is at a distance of 1 unit from the x-axis. What is its line equation? Y equal to 1. Now, take one more line which is parallel to x-axis. Now it is a line parallel to x-axis. Now here this distance is 1 unit, this distance is 2 units, so this point coordinates can be taken as 1, 2. Now see here, this distance is 2 units, this distance is 2 units, this is 2 units, this is 2 units, so this point coordinates can be taken as 2, 2. This distance is 3 units. This distance is 2 units. So, this corresponding point coordinates can be taken as 3, 2. Come to the left side of that line. Now, this distance is 1 unit. This distance is 2 units. So, this point coordinates can be taken as minus 1, 2. Next, this distance is 2 units. This distance is also 2 units. So, this point coordinates can be taken as minus 2, 2. If you observe all these points, its y coordinate value is 2. So, this line equation can be taken as y equals to 2. So, clearly, it is a line parallel to x-axis and it is at a distance of 2 units from the x-axis. Its line equation is y equal to 2. Now draw one more line which is parallel to x-axis. Now clearly this line is parallel to x-axis. Now here this distance is 1 unit, this distance is also 1 unit because this point coordinates are 0, minus 1. So this distance is 1 unit, this distance is 1 unit. So this point coordinates can be taken as 1, minus 1. Next, this distance is 2 units, this distance is 1 unit only, this point coordinates can be taken as 2, minus 1. Next, this distance is 3 units, this distance is 1 unit, this corresponding point coordinates can be taken as 3, minus 1. Now come to the left side of the same line. This distance is 1 unit, this distance is also 1 unit, so this point coordinates can be taken as minus 1, minus 1. Next, this distance is 2 units, this distance is 1 unit, so this point coordinates can be taken as minus 2, minus 1. If you observe all these points, its y coordinate value is -1. So this line equation can be taken as y equals to -1. In general, equation of any line parallel to x-axis is of the form y equals to some constant k. So equation of a line parallel to x-axis is of the form y equals to some constant k. Now here y equal to k represents a straight line which is parallel to x-axis and is at a distance of k units from the x-axis. If the value of k is positive, then the line which lies above the x-axis. If the value of k is negative, the line which lies below the x-axis. See once again, equation of any line parallel to x-axis is of the form y equals to some constant k. So y equal to k equation represents a line which is parallel to x-axis and it is at a distance of k units from the x-axis. If the value of k is positive, the line lies above the x-axis. If the value of k is negative, the line lies below the x-axis. Now come to the next point, fourth point, equation of the line parallel to y-axis. Now how to find out equation of a line parallel to y-axis? First draw the coordinate axis. So it is x-axis, it is y-axis. Now here we need the equation of a line parallel to y-axis. Suppose this is 1, this is 2, it is -1, it is -2 on y-axis also. Suppose this is 1, this is 2. On negative y-axis it is -1, it is -2. Now draw a line parallel to y-axis. Now clearly this line is parallel to y-axis. Now here this 2 is nothing but this point coordinates are 2, 0. This point coordinates are 1, 0. Here on y-axis 1 unit means this point coordinates are 0, 1. Here this point coordinates are 0, 2. This is the point 0, -1. It is 0, -2. It is -1, 0. -2, 0. Now here in the diagram, this length is 2 units. This length is 1 unit. Now this point coordinates can be taken as 2, 1. Again, this length is 2 units. This length is also 2 units. This corresponding point coordinates can be taken as 2, 2. Now here, come to the line below x-axis. This length is 2 units. This length is 1 unit. So, this point coordinates can be taken as 2, -1. Now here, this length is 2 units. This length is also 2 units. This point coordinates can be taken as 2, -2. Now, if you observe all the points on this line, x coordinate value is 2. So, this line equation can be taken as x equal to 2. What you are doing? Just we are drawing a line parallel to x-axis. And we denote some points on that line. If you observe all the points on the line, x coordinate value is same and the x coordinate value is equals to 2. So equation of this line can be written as x equal to 2. Now draw one more line which is parallel to y-axis. Suppose this is the line parallel to, 1 minute. This is the pointer -2, 0. Suppose this is the line parallel to y-axis. Now here, denote some points on this line. Here, this length is 2 units. This length is 1 unit. This point coordinates can be taken as -2, 1. Again, this length is 2 units. This length is 2 units. This point coordinates can be taken as -2, +2. This length is 1 unit. This length is 2 units. This point coordinates can be taken as -2, -1. This length is 2 units. This length is also 2 units. So this point coordinates can be taken as -2, -2. Now here, if you observe all these points, whose x coordinate value is equals to -2. So equation of this line can be taken as x equal to -2. Here we are getting equation of a line parallel to y-axis is x equal to 2. Here it is a line parallel to y-axis whose equation is x equal to -2. In general, equation of any line parallel to y-axis is of the form x equal to some constant k. So equation of the line parallel to y-axis is of the form x equals to k. X equal to k represents a straight line parallel to y-axis and it is at a distance of k units from the y-axis. If the value of k is positive, the line lies on right side of y-axis. If the value of k is negative, the line lies on left side of y-axis. Now here we are going to discussing 4 points. Once again, I can reveal all the 4 points once again. First one, equation of x-axis. Equation of x-axis is y equals to 0. Next one, equation of y-axis. Equation of y-axis is x equal to 0. Third one, equation of any line parallel to x-axis is of the form y equal to some constant. Take that constant term as k. Fourth one, equation of a line parallel to y-axis is of the form x equal to some constant. Take that constant term as k. Now, see an example related to the previous concept, basic line equations. Write the equation of the line parallel to x-axis, which is 4 units above it. Equation of a line parallel to x-axis is of the form y equals to k. If k is positive, the line lies above x-axis. If k is negative, the line lies below the x-axis. Here, required line is parallel to x-axis, which is 4 units above the x-axis. So, come to the answer to the first problem. Equation of a line parallel to x-axis, which is 4 units distance from x-axis and above it. Now, we need this line equation. Find the equation of the line which is at a distance of 4 units from the x-axis and it lies above x-axis. So, what is the equation of this line? Equation of any line parallel to x-axis is of the form y equals to some constant k. If k is positive, the line lies above x-axis. If k is negative, the line lies below x-axis. Here, required line is at a distance of 4 units and above x-axis. So, what is the equation of this line? Y equals to 4. Then come to the second problem. The line parallel to x-axis, which is at a distance of 2 units below it. It means, first you draw the x-axis. Now draw a line parallel to x-axis and below x-axis. Now this required line is at a distance of 2 units. Equation of any line parallel to x-axis is of the form y equals to k. K value positive means this line lies above x-axis. K value negative means this line lies below x-axis. So required line is parallel to x-axis and it is at a distance of 2 units and below x-axis. So equation of the required line can be taken as y equal to minus 2. Then come to the third problem. Write the equation of the line parallel to y-axis, which is at a distance of 5 units to right of it. Now first draw a rough diagram related to the given condition. Now take the coordinate axis. This is y-axis, it is x-axis. Now draw a line parallel to y-axis. Now this is a line parallel to y-axis. Suppose this line is at a distance of 5 units from the y-axis. Equation of any line parallel to y-axis is of the form x equal to k. If the value of k is positive, the line lies on right side of x-axis. If the value of k is negative, the line lies on left side of y-axis. Here, required line is lies on right side of y-axis. So, its equation can be taken as x equal to 5. So, equation of a line parallel to y-axis, which is at a distance of 5 units, to the right side of y-axis is x equal to 5. Now, come to the fourth bit. Write the equation of the line parallel to y-axis, which is at a distance of 7 units to the left side of y-axis. Now again, take the coordinate axis, y-axis, x-axis. Suppose this is a line parallel to y-axis and it is at a distance of 7 units from the y-axis and lies on left side of y-axis. Now this point coordinates can be taken as -7, 0. Now clearly this line is parallel to y-axis. Equation of any line parallel to y-axis and which lies on left side of y-axis and it is at a distance of 7 units is x equal to -7. So answer to the first bit will be y equal to 4. For the second bit, y equal to -2. Third question, x equal to 5. Fourth one, x equal to -7.